The 34-year-old killer, Yoo Young-cho, lured women working in massage parlors to his home, killed them with a blunt weapon, mutilated their bodies, and buried them in the mountains in Seoul.
There could be 100 victims.
This type of case was unprecedented in Korea at the time. And we had no idea at all, no inkling as to what type of person the killer was.
But as more cases arose, we became certain that this was committed by one person.
I was under a lot of stress because of this case.
Her skull was dented so badly that I couldn't tell what the assailant had used to inflict such damage.
He developed the murder weapon himself, so that it would fit his grip perfectly.
Dozens of women were murdered in that bathroom. Even if the blood had been washed away, when trace elements of that are detected, luminol produces light. Then I looked up at the ceiling. There was flesh. It was all there. All the spatters.
Is he a lunatic?
I was in utter shock.
The task at hand is very much like solving a complicated puzzle, piece by piece.
It was in our heads. In Seoul, a city where 10 million people live.
Around 200 people were on the case.
But there was footage that was captured by chance.
We lost him because we had let our guard down. He was basically giving us the runaround.
But his later crimes revealed his true character.
I thought, we're screwed if we don't catch him.